Reversible lanes. What do they mean? Well, for a concept that is very complicated, it's actually pretty simple. Now, for most of you out there, y'all may not have seen a reversible lane. Now, you normally see this around areas that have something to do with lane control signals, such as this one right here. You normally see them, like, okay, so let me give you an example. So a great example of this is that near AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, there are reversible lanes near Division and another one of the streets that connects up to Interstate 30. So with this video, I'm going to give you a basic rundown on what exactly reversible lanes do and their initial purposes. So normally, reversible lanes are the same thing as our normal lane, except you have to deal with the dashed double lines. Now, for those of you that have never seen this before, you might be thinking, okay, so I've seen single stripe dashes and I've seen double yellow solid lines, but I've never seen the mix before. Well, the mix is it's those two combined, but the catch is that the lane control signals determines which lanes are active. So I'm gonna run it, and this is basically what it's gonna indicate. So as you can see right here, from both directions, this says that this lane right here in this lane is for traffic that's going this way, and then these two lanes right here are traffic that is coming towards me. That's literally all that is. And these are like indicating as the dashes, and this is like the solid yellow, like the solid double yellow lines, if that makes any sense. So they're dashed and they're also double yellow lines to indicate to traffic that you can still cross over, but if you're crossing over into another lane that is oncoming, that instance could be a solid double line. Now, if we were to change that a little bit, let's say that I'm going to run it and I'm going to be in person this time, what's going to happen is that I'm going to change the lanes 1 and 2 to indicate that the traffic direction is going to change. Now, if I can go up and activate the bar or the little thing. Well, okay, so I think it'll take a little bit of time for it to load. But normally what happens is that whenever you change it, it's supposed to go, so these lanes are about to shut down, theoretically, and when they become red, these become green, and all the lanes are going off into this direction. And now all of these lines are indicated as dashes, since they're all in the same, so vehicles can merge over to other lanes. And same thing vice versa, like if two sides were to shut down and then go the other way, it'll be in that same process. But let's say, for example, that this lane is as is, and then this lane switches along, and these two, or these three, are the same direction. So these two would be dashes, so vehicles can cross over to other lanes, but this one would be a solid yellow line where they can't cross over. Mainly because there's a red X or people that are going this direction to indicate that you can't cross over. So hopefully, that was a short and sweet tutorial on what reversible lanes do. I tried my best to explain it in a way that made sense. And in my opinion, I think it did make sense, but if y'all are having any difficulties, then just use the Beautiful Roads plugin and test it out yourself and see what you can make of it. And then when it finally clicks, you're like, oh, okay, now it's making sense. So anyway, that's just a quick little tutorial on what reversible lanes do, since many of y'all have not seen this function in action before. So I might as well just save y'all the pain on what it actually does. But it's a really cool feature. It's a cool feature that you can do in cities, specifically with lane control signals. Now, you really can't do that easily on interstates. Keep that in mind. Interstates is a different story, like with tunnels. But when it comes down to this, then this is a great example of how to use reversible lanes. So anyway, I hope y'all enjoyed. If you all did, then please leave a like and subscribe down below. It's always free. You can always unsubscribe whenever you don't want to subscribe to me anymore. I'm perfectly fine with it. I'm here for the fun.